But I'll change it, change it.
What did you put on my head?
Say hi, guys.
Hi, guys.
Welcome back to our channel. Okay, guys. You're welcome back to my channel, and it's so amazing to have you. Thank you so much for always clicking, especially my returning subscribers. You guys are the main MVP, and it's so amazing to have you click my videos whenever you see them, okay? And of course, if you're seeing my face for the first time, I am Naija Princess, and it's so good, like so good to have you drop by, okay? And please do well to subscribe to my channel, like don't forget to subscribe. If you have not subscribed, just do it now. It's just so simple. Just click on the subscribe button here right now, hit on that subscribe button, and do give this video a thumbs up, okay? So today I'm going to be sharing my story about how I became homeless in Uganda. You guys, this Nigerian girl actually became homeless in this country. Oh my god. So a few weeks ago, something happened in my former apartment, and I was very sick. I don't know if you guys watched my video when I was finally difficult to talk, and I had to just do that video because it's been long. I actually posted video on my channel. So I actually, you know, was very, very sick at the time. And I noticed there was water leaking in my bathroom, and also water was not really moving very, very well. So I decided to, you know, call the owner of the apartment. Now, one thing about here is that most of the apartments are being managed by the owner of the house, instead of, you know, they don't give it out to real estate agents or to manage the house. So some of them are being managed by the owner of the apartment. So I had to call the landlord, and I said, okay, Nora, stop. So I told the landlord that my water was leaking, and of course that I also noticed that there was water gathering in my bathroom, and I needed him to call the plumber to come fix it. He said, okay, and he's going to send the plumber over. So that particular plumber came, I had to show him where the water has been leaking for days, okay? So, and that I don't even know, I just noticed, I woke up and I noticed that water was clustering. So the day he was supposed to come, actually didn't come, he came the next day. And when he came, I told him, the guys checked, and I was like, I can't find the water leaking. I said, water is leaking. I had to be the one to bend down. I was really shivering, like I bent down, showed him where the water was leaking and all. You know, that's when he said, okay, he left my room. Then this guy went outside. I don't know, I heard he waited and waited for long. I don't know what he was waiting for. Somebody I showed what to do. So I went back to lie down, I covered my duvet, and I didn't know. Later, my neighbor came to, you know, check on us and also take Elira to go better. So when she came, she said that I asked her, I said, did you see the plumber? She said, he's outside. I said, okay. So I was thinking maybe he's fixing something or so. So I heard he was outside. I was thinking he was actually fixing something. And my dad, later, I waited for him for hours. I didn't see him. Elora, can you stop jumping?
Don't be on the
bed. Yeah, you should stop jumping on the chair. So I actually waited for him. He didn't come for hours. I was looking. Maybe he had fixed it. I went to the bathroom. The water was still leaking at all. So I had to call. I waited till evening. I saw the askari, which is the gateman. I called him and I was like, what happened? I didn't see the plumber you came with again. What happened? He left. He said that he has been waiting for me outside, that he got angry and said he has been waiting for me and I never showed up. I'm like, what is he waiting for me for? Am I the one that will walk on this stuff? So when he said that, I said, okay. So I went back to my bed. So later, I saw the water was gathering, and my daughter couldn't even use the restroom except me standing up, carrying her to the restroom to go and clean the place. So I decided to, you know, go in there, look for a solution. So I got a broom, then I went to the place the water was gathering, and I started putting the broom inside so that the water can flow out. So the water, the airways, the place was cleared. Okay, Elora, stop jumping. And the water started flowing. Later in the evening, I called the house owner and I said, I don't know what happened. Your plumber came and he left. What happened? He said that the plumber had told him how I'm mismanaging his house, and he's going to come to call, to check on the house, and at the end, then he will make a decision. I said, okay, how have you managing your house? Mismanaging your house? I don't understand. Anyway, you guys can come. He said he's going to come in the afternoon, and I said, okay. So in the morning hours the next day, I reached out to him. I said, I'm still waiting for you guys. Please make sure you come earlier enough. So he later came around to it because I was already pissed with him. This is because when I moved into that place, there was this other white woman and her husband that was living in the compound. The daughter was my daughter's friend. So when I came in, she told me, okay, that they were moving out. The guy had given them eviction notice, and that she was complaining he doesn't like fixing the house, and he just keep collecting rent. They will call him to come and do plumber work. He'll complain. He just keep complaining about everything. So they told him that they were moved. Okay, he came and told them that he was tired, that they should move out of the house for him. That if I'm ready to manage that and all. But this was the only house that appealed to me when among all the houses that the agents took me to. So I was like, how will I tell him to refund my money? I had already paid, and I was like, how will I tell this guy to refund my money and all? So she advised me that maybe after the 2 months I can just leave and all. So I said, okay, because I wanted to tour around Uganda, although it's actually not easy, you know, touring around Uganda with my baby. So I was like, okay, maybe after these 2 months, if I'm not able to go back, then I could look for another apartment. So these guys actually moved out. He refunded them part of their money and they moved out. So a few days after they moved out, somebody came to rob us in the house, okay? The person was trying to open my door, and the person has a spare key to my door. And the person was trying to open my door. So that day, my neighbor had called me earlier that she would come to, because we're just two ladies then. It was a new apartment, it was renovated. So we just have two ladies in the compound. We have three ladies in compound, one in front, two at the back, me and my and one other person. Then one guy at the back, one guy in front. The other apartments were very empty. So this guy had a spare key. We actually was suspecting that it was an askari. So he came, tried to open the door, and I heard the sound. I thought maybe my neighbor, because I didn't really lock the protector inside, because my neighbor had called, she was coming to my room to sleep that night. I said, okay. So I waited. I came outside and I said, is that you? I called her name. Is that you? Nobody answered. I said, is that you? Nobody answered. My spirit said, I went back. And when I lied down, my spirit said, go and lock your door. So immediately I went back and I locked my door. I locked it properly and I locked the protector properly. Then I went back to sleep. Later on, the person came back to my door again, trying to open my door. And I was now screaming. I was shouting, askari, askari, can you hear me? Who can hear me? Nobody answered. So later, my neighbor now called me and said, Princess, somebody is trying to open my door. That's her own door. Someone was trying to open the door. And the person has a key. The person was slotting in key, but her key was already at the back. And she started screaming too. Both of us were actually screaming at the same time. And we started calling the askari's number. His phone was switched off. A few hours down the line, this thing was happening to you around 4 a.m. It started around 2 a.m. till 4 a.m. way. Somebody was still trying to open her door. The lady in front said somebody was also trying to open her door with a spare key. And the person was pushing her door and all. The person was not able to open her door. So I was screaming. I was so scared that night. We were hearing movement everywhere. And we have a gate. We have a security guy. So what's happening? You guys, later on, the askari's phone started ringing at my neighbor's window. And I was calling him at that time. His phone just rang and he switched off his phone. That's how we started suspecting that it was the askari. So I started screaming. I said, askari, I know you are the one. I've heard your phone rang. Okay, my neighbor had already told me that askari's phone, that somebody's phone is ringing by the side. Then we started screaming again. Nobody answered. I called the number again. The number went off again. So in the morning, I had already sent the landlord some messages somebody's trying to open our door last night. We're trying to open our door and all. The guy never replied. I called him constantly to see if he can call security or so. What is it? No, stop going there. Mommy is doing a video, okay? So I had already called him. He was not picking my calls. He was not responding to messages. So I said, okay. Then the next morning, he called me early in the morning. I said, Princess, I saw your missed calls. I left my phone in the parlor, blah, blah, blah. I said, okay, somebody was trying to open our door last night. And this guy said he was coming. He came, he went to the askari, only for him to knock at my door and said, Princess, nobody actually came to your door. I had asked the askari and he said nobody. Like, how do you ask askari that his phone was off, askari that we were shouting at, calling his name and he was not talking? And of course this person had a spare key. Who else this guy was all like, who else has a spare key to my room, to our rooms? So that day we all made a decision that you should give us all our spare keys, that we don't want anyone to have our spare keys. So that was it. So I got furious with him that I was like, how will you trust an askari over your tenant? I don't understand. This is our security. Then we do not want this askari again. We need a new askari. Because sometimes we see him drinking with his friends in the other apartment where the white woman had moved out. So we told him that we don't want him again. He said, hey, that we should give him some time. He has to travel and stay for a month. When he comes back, blah, blah, blah. So everybody was calm, but I'm not really a calm person. I'm not that person. I take my security very seriously. I had to tell him, I said, I don't like the way you actually do things. When people tell you about their security, when people tell you about their house and all, you just take them for granted. It doesn't make sense. And I paid you for this apartment. It's not for free. So the guy was like, oh, Princess, you give me time to look for security. And everybody was like, get a professional security guy. Don't get somebody that from the village, who don't even know him, he's not trustworthy at all. Elora, stop that. So you guys, the whole thing ended. Then we waited for the whole month. The guy finally brought somebody else from the village. After promising us he was going to get a professional guard. So he brought somebody from the village. So okay, before then I had already told him that my roof was leaking. He took this guy over 3 weeks to come and fix the roof that was leaking. In fact, he came and he told me that that it's because I'm cooking in the room that's why the roof is leaking. I'm like, you built your kitchen in the room, and this is not the first house I'm living that has a kitchen in the room. In Kenya, it's the same thing. It's only Nigeria that will build kitchens apart. Although some houses in Kenya and also here also have their kitchens apart, but this guy built his kitchen in the parlor, and the same place I'm living here, the Airbnb I'm staying currently, the kitchen is also in the parlor. This is my sitting room. The kitchen is that way. And I told him, I said, this is not because I'm cooking here. This is because the roof is leaking. Look at the map. And I took him to my room. I showed him the map too of where the whole water was leaking. That's how he said, okay, I'm going to send somebody. I waited for first week, second week, third week. He didn't show. Now, when he came with this plumber, he told me he was going to come with the plumber that day. He came. And after the plumber, I said, you said that I spoiled the house. Okay, the plumber came and stood straight. He couldn't talk. He was just dumb. Then the landlord told the plumber, what did you see happen to the room, to the place? The guy said, that water was clustered here. And I asked him, I said, water was clustered? Why did I call you? I called you to fix the water that was clustered, and I called you that the water was leaking. And you left. Now I did work of a plumber. You've not seen a water clustering somewhere before. You went to go and gossip because you're looking for cheap something from him or something. He said, no, that I did not go and gossip. Just went to tell him, blah, blah, blah. I said, you are a gossip. That's why you don't greet people. I'm like, you have problem with women. You are very, very, you know, you have problem. So I told him, I said, you have problem with women. That's why when you see us, you know, especially me, whenever he sees me, he wants me to greet him. Very small boy, yo. Whenever he sees me, he wants me to greet him. So when I moved in, I was always greeting this guy until one day I noticed that if I don't say hello, he won't say hello. So I stopped. And I'm like, you have problem. You have issues. You have pride. And you have a very stupid, you know, low self-esteem around women. You should try to grow. So you want to use me to go and gossip because of one rubbish you're going to get from him. And I didn't talk to both of them. I allowed them. I said, okay, go and check the house. The guy went to the other back to, and I said, I should flush my toilet. I flushed it. Then water came in. I said, actually, that nothing happened. I said, okay, you gotta stop now. I said, okay. I said, thank you. He left. So later I sent the landlord message and I said, I don't like the fact that each time someone complains to you that something is wrong, especially if I complain to you, tell me one thing or the other, you can't even come and fix the thing. You cannot, do something about it. And at the end of the day, you make excuses and you try to put the blame on me. The guy never replied. And I said, and another thing I noticed is that you like people telling you gossip. And when you hear it, you just start acting on whatever thing you heard. And you start writing whatever thing you want to write. And I'm like, please, any day you're tired of me staying in your house, let me know and I'm going to move out. He didn't say a word. Then my rent was going to expire the next week. He didn't write me to you. My rent expired on the 11th and on the 11th of August, and on the 10th, he sent me a message and like, dear princess, because of what the neighbors had complained that your daughter disturbs them at night, that she always cries in the midnight, so I have decided, and invading of neighbors' privacy and blah blah blah, I have decided to let you go. I'm so sorry, it's not my decision, and blah blah blah. You guys, I just sent me a message. I said, I'm the one that told you that any day you're tired of me staying, you should let me know and I'll leave. Don't try to write a message of lies. Don't try to, lie against the neighbors, because all of us were very close and everyone was using my internet. So nobody would say I did anything to them. I was in my room. I was always in my room, my daughter, and we don't go out. Do you understand? And how can a neighbor come to say that? So I started asking everybody, please, I'm sorry, what did I do to you guys? You said this, you said that. Everybody's like, Aprisa, we never said anything about you. And nobody said. And when I confronted him, he said it was the neighbors that should not mind them. They told him not to lie, not to tell me who he was and all. Then he told me it was 5 neighbors and we're just few of us at the back there. Then later, he was not asking me, my closest neighbor, do I trust who that person is? That person, do I know if the person is the person that came to gossip? Then I confronted the lady. The lady said that she not even mind that she cannot say such a thing. Or like, I said, I trust you cannot say such a thing. Don't worry, I already know who this guy is. Then he actually, he now went to that my neighbor that were close to go tell the person that it was 3 people that told him. Now it's no longer 5. So when I asked these other people that we share internet, and they were like, Princess, we never said so. That they were even surprised I said I was moving. My people, that was how I became homeless. So. And this guy gave me just a few days. My rent is expiring on the 11th. And he's expecting me to move on the 11th. I told him, you have to give me 2 weeks for me to look for an apartment. So I actually looked for a service apartment because I just have a few weeks to stay before going back. So I told him that have few weeks to move out to travel back home. Can I pay for a month and before I leave? And I said that won't be need, that somebody had already paid for the house. I said okay. So he came to my house that day to pick me. I told him to bring the other people to come and check the house. I should come check the house, then he can give me my deposit that I gave him. Because here you give deposit of the same amount you paid for rent. He came and told me, I have to give him 1 week to raise the money. To bring the money so I can. He said I should give him 1 month, 1 month for him to leave. I said, I just have a few weeks to leave. You can't tell me that in 1 month and I need to pay for my rent. He now said, okay, that I should give him to the next week. I waited the first week, second week. This guy did not give me my money. Then, that was it all. Finally, when he sent me my money, this guy removed like 135,000 from the 400K I gave to him. Removed 135K. I was like, that the few days I spent in the house, I was not expecting him, that he does not run a charity organization. I'm not expecting him to not collect the money that I use water and light. I was like, I use water and light for how many days before I moved out? Like, I told him to give me 2 weeks. I did not even use 1 week before I got to an apartment where I'm currently staying. And you collected 130K from me. Said 70K was for painting. I said, no problem. Because I know my baby actually drew some things on the wall. I was like, okay, take the 70K for painting. He now said I had to pay Yaka 27,000 for a few days I spent. I didn't spend up to 5 days, you guys. 27,000. He collected 20k for water. I did not spend 1 month. Why am I paying water bill? Then he collected extra money for whatever. He now said that the few days I stayed, he does not run his charity organization, that I have to pay him and blah, 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 that I should consider, I should behave, that he's trying to be good around me, that me, I want to be bad around him, I don't want to consider at all. I was really mad. But I just told him, I said, it shows that you're a greedy person. And what that woman told me was actually true about you. You're a greedy person. You try to be friends with me, and at the end of the day, you actually turn out bad. And you try to cheat me of my money. So somebody will cheat you of your money one day. So you can take the money. It was 135,000. I don't know how much that is in Naira. I think that's about 13K or thereabout. So I was like, you can have the money. Just you take it and enjoy yourself. What is it? It's going to finish one day now. Abi has not finished. So you have the money. I know I'm bigger than you. And any day, anytime, I'm bigger than you. But one day, once somebody's going to cheat you of that same money. And I blocked him. That was it, you guys. But I was able to get an off-service apartment here. Okay, we're going to be staying here in the next few weeks before going back home. Okay. But we're still here for a few weeks. We want to actually travel to Jinja. But I don't know how that is going to be, because the lady that is supposed to take us, she's been at work and we've been waiting for a while. I don't know if it's still going to be possible. But if it's not going to be possible, we'll just go ahead and book our reservation for flights. And so we're just here for a few weeks, and that's been it. But I'm going to show you guys what my current service apartment looks like. It's furnished, it's very amazing. Okay, but I'm going to show you everything, then I tell you the pros and cons of living here, some of the things I've also experienced living here, okay, in this service apartment. I'm going to tell you about that, okay, on my next video. You guys, thank you so much for watching. That's my experience, that's what I've seen here, that's what I've experienced here. Like, it was very terrible. There are also good people out there. Is this guy just him? Okay, it's just his lifestyle. Is I'm not saying this is people living in Kampala, this is their lifestyle. No, it is just this guy's lifestyle. He's a greedy person, he's a cheat, he's whatever, and he just prefers to take money without fixing his house, and he wants you to also, you know, just be, you know, begging him for everything. And I'm not that woman. And I feel he also has issue with women. Like, he doesn't like women confronting him. I'm a woman and he did this. He did that to that other lady who is also a white woman. And the husband of that lady is actually very calm. But she is not really that calm. She's like me. And I noticed the same thing he did to me is the same thing he did to her. So he has issues with women. He's actually a very, he has low self-esteem. Yeah. He has low self-esteem. He doesn't like seeing a woman maybe progressing or doing better or trying to speak out. He doesn't like it. So he has issues. It's his personality, not everybody's personality. I've seen people here living in apartments and they're comfortable. They're foreigners. They're okay. Some of my friends, they live here, around here, and they're comfortable. No issues with landlords and all. So it's his personality. He has problems. And I wish he would see this video and get himself and his head checked. The guy is a very, very, very... Let me not go ahead and say what I want to say. Anyway, let me just end it here. You guys, thank you so much for watching. And thank you so much. If you have not subscribed, please do hit the subscribe button. Subscribe to my channel. Like my videos. And see you next time. Bye, guys. Bye.